Welcome to the Wrestle Ropes podcast, a very special edition. As you may notice on the title card, it's not a Scottish wrestling show, but I'll explain all momentarily. But I'm joined by my co-host this evening as we're going through this preview of the event. It is CCW producer, it's Lou King Sharp. Welcome back to the show.
Let's do it. Looking forward to it.
Can't wait. I'm glad to have you back on. At least I found a reason to get you back on to recording because we had so much fun in our first actual podcast chat, which I think that was about a 2 hour.
Yeah.
About 2 hours of nonsense. And then of course, yeah, they did the mosh pit as well, which was about the same amount of time. So, but no, this is a little bit different. So, like I say, for people listening or watching, it's about Copenhagen Championship Wrestling Grunge, which is coming this Saturday at the Sports Factory in Copenhagen. But yeah, we're speaking about it. We're previewing the show because I'm joined, like I say, by CCW producer Lou King Sharp. How did you get involved with CCW?
So my sort of relationship with CCW goes right back to when it started. It was actually the Copenhagen Hangman, a former CCW heavyweight champion who was running it at the time. It was him that sort of founded CCW. So he was running it at the time, and Sebastian Day was kind of helping him out. I knew Sebastian through DPW. We were working at Dance for Wrestling together. We'd just been traveling together. I would stay with Sebastian and his family when I was in Copenhagen. So I was just kind of around a lot when they were shooting a lot of the CCW stuff and filming a lot of stuff. So I actually kind of was involved in producing sort of promos and like segments and stuff before I'd actually even wrestled there. So that was my introduction to it, was the sort of producing aspect of it. But in terms of being a wrestler, just from there, the sort of relationship just grew. Obviously, I wanted to get involved in CCW physically. So I ended up, I went over for a week-long training camp. I trained a lot of guys there. We brought over some of the Scottish guys as well, some guys who you've seen on network and stuff now, Jimmy Pierce, Logan Smith, even Jonathan Richards was there before. He was an American. That was my first CCW show was at the end of that camp, and it was 100 mile an hour since then.
I mean, you really kind of embraced, you're one of the guys that kind of broke into the Scandinavian scene anyway, because those are the reasons why I really heard about CCW and all these places, because you were just wrestling everywhere in Europe at that point. But it was Copenhagen. Was that just as soon as you got there and did that camp? Was it just that was you knew that was going to be your kind of second home, so to speak?
I clicked with a lot of the wrestlers. We always got on really well. As I said, always had a really good relationship with Sebastian. And just in general, for the guys that were there, I believed in the Danish scene. And I wanted more people to kind of know about it, which, as you mentioned, I spent a lot of time promoting it and stuff at the time. I still do. Aside from obviously my relationship with the wrestlers, just I feel like the Copenhagen fans have always really embraced me. And I've always had a sort of good reaction from them when I go over there. It's always a pleasure wrestling in front of them as well. So I guess just overall, it was just, I was really enjoying it. I had a lot of passion for that sort of scene specifically, not even just Denmark, the Scandinavian scene in general. I thought there was a lot of wrestlers there who were really talented, and maybe not as many people were seeing them as they could be. And I just wanted to do what I could to help help these guys go there, help the scene get bigger. And I just be part of like a kind of a young wrestling scene. It's an exciting thing to kind of be part of, to see, CCW is a perfect example of it. The first CCW show I did, I think there was maybe 20 people there if that, that was pushing it. And then, I've done CCW shows where there's been 400 people. So they're doing big numbers, and CCW is, it's certainly grown a lot since I started going there on the Danish scene, with Body Slam and DPW and everything else as well. It's just blown up. So, as I said, it's just exciting to get to be part of that and have been part of it since the start.
That's the reason why we've kind of done this preview as well, because not only because you're so heavily involved with CCW, but you're bringing over some some Scottish talent as well, which we'll get into when we go through the match card and it's in itself, and also some past guests through the Sharp Dojo series when we did the podcast through that as well. So there'll be a lot of familiar names, I'm hoping, for people that are listening and have listened to past episodes. We'll just park that for a brief moment, because last time we spoke was about a year ago, maybe, something like that. It felt like a while ago. How are you doing, just in general? How are you getting on?
Good, really good. I've just moved into a new house, so you'll need to excuse my towel curtains that I have at the moment. But I am just doing my usual, just blood touring and trying to get about everywhere that I can, try to get my face out there, and I just try to make as much noise as possible and have a good time. How about yourself?
Not bad. I mean, this will be the first proper episode I can put out that I've announced that Kelly's pregnant. So that's been a bit wild. Thank you very much. So yeah, we kind of got the same situation. We're doing up the house, so that's why I've got no curtains. We got new windows and painted and blinds. Apparently, take like 4 weeks to arrive, and I didn't know that.
Well, I can recommend towels. Towels will do the trick.
But no, I didn't know that. So our bedroom is going to have no. I once I wake up in the morning, if it's not the blackout dark, I can't get back to sleep. So if the dog wakes me up at 6:30 in the morning, that is me. I am up at that time. I'm not getting back to sleep. So it's been a very tiring week, and I've got another like 3-4 weeks to do it. So it's training. I call it training for a child. That's it. I just didn't realize it was going to be so much of a faff, but that's not exciting chat to go on about with my windows. But at least I've got my stuff back up. That's fine. I've got my wall of crap back up and going. I'm enjoying your background there. Some I've seen WCW, is that magazines?
I got some comic books going on there. So I got the WCW comic and the Undertaker and Steve Austin comics, the Chaos comics from back in the day. So I've been checking them out, and then I got my games wall going on.
Wow.
Yeah. So that's pretty. I've been enjoying this.
That is incredible. That's. Yeah. I mean, I've seen you put up some bits and pieces on Instagram, but I didn't realise that it was getting that way.
Yeah, this is, you know, that's like, that isn't even all of it. Cover behind me, like, we got like cartridges and yeah, Evan. So hopefully there's going to be a YouTube channel coming at some point where I'm going to actually make use of some of this. But aye, that's the collection now.
Yeah, amazing. Makes my collection look crap. I mean, the only thing that's cool there now is the belt. That's about it. Even then,
it's a sick belt. It's a sick belt.
Ah, but you've got like got some of your own hanging about, I'm sure. But no, I'm actually just in awe of that whole wall. Just kind of reset myself for a little bit. But no, you've been half a busy. You've been wrestling all over the place. You're not just doing the Blood Tourist. You've got this psychedelic thing going on as well.
I'm trying some different stuff. I guess just the way the Blood Tourist thing kind of came about. Just want to keep things different. Keep inventing myself. Well, reinventing myself. Sorry. I always enjoyed it when I kind of wore the jeans and I was starting out all the different kind of bright colours, and when I started doing the Blood Tour and stuff, everything was a bit more dark, and I thought, well, let's kind of try and merge the two a bit, so I've got some brighter coloured gear and stuff now, and I just try to do something a wee bit different, keep it fresh.
And of course, yeah, I've seen the mask embroiderers work as well, a lot of different kind of patches that you're getting now.
He is a lifesaver. He's brilliant. I couldn't recommend him enough. Anytime anyone's talking about ring jackets or any of that kind of stuff, like he's the guy. Like I can give him like a rough idea that is very poorly explained, and he sends back excellence. You know what I mean? Every single time he's done me, my face. It's like twice now he's done my face on my. On my gear, he's done a Cheech and Chong set that I wore for the Square Go. He's done all sorts of them. The Super Mario set that I've been wearing around. He's brilliant. If you can think of it, he can do it. He's the guy.
It was the fists. You got your face and the fists. I remember cutting them out for 2K20 and trying to put them on your gear. I thought that's amazing to look at. And another thing that you've been busy when you've done, of course, you're still doing WWE Network via ICW. You're doing all that kind of stuff. But you also became W3L heavyweight champion as well. So no, it's all go in Luke King Sharp's world, it seems.
Absolutely. I'm just back from a tour of England with W3L. I got the poster behind me actually. So we done Todd Morden, we done
This was Stockton on Tees and Airbra,
I believe that says. Yeah. So but it was three brilliant shows. Honestly, I think people are sleeping on W3L. Like, I think it's one of the most exciting kind of promotions in Scotland just now. They're bringing in a lot of new faces, and there's a lot of exciting stuff going on. They got Iceman coming back, which, if you're a kind of old school British wrestling fan like me, then you'll know that, you know, back in the day, Iceman was the guy. So I was pretty excited to see that. So I'll be keeping my eye on him as well. But obviously, Iceman's a deathmatch legend, so that's pretty exciting.
Of course, then, of course, you just missed out on a match with Nathan Reynolds, of course, because he had COVID, so that was missed out in Remedy, but I'm sure that he's going to be up and around. I'm just hoping that you're champion round about the time that they do their North tour again, so you can explore the delights of Elgin.
See, I had to miss out on they done Northern tour recently, and I had to miss out on that. I can't remember where, but I was gutted to miss out on that, but I'm sure I'll be up for the next one.
But I think I contacted you. I think you were abroad, so you know, just do blood tourist stuff. but it was a very interesting show. But I've mentioned it in other podcasts, so I'm not gonna go into it again. But no, it was personally, it wasn't one of the best ones they've done in Elgin. But there's always next year. I'm not gonna write them off just because of one show. That's
the right. The King Sharp's back. It'll pick back up.
That's it. I'm gonna. We'll drag Kelly. We'll drag whatever child spawn has come from that, and we'll be there to cheer on Luke King Sharp. Even though I don't think you should be cheered. I don't know. I'm trying to keep up with W3L. It's kind of difficult because they put everything on their network and then they put everything on their behind paywall. I'm like, I need to keep up with this stuff. How? Anyway, this isn't about W3L. It's not a W3L podcast. This is Copenhagen Championship Wrestling. Let's just get into some matches then. So, information about the show for those that are listening that are thinking of traveling to Denmark this weekend. Why not? You can do. It's at the Sports Factory in Copenhagen, Saturday, March 12th, door 6 p.m., first bell 7 p.m. More information, facebook.com/CPHWrestling or twitter.com/CPHWrestling1. It's a TV taping, so that's pretty exciting.
Definitely. The CCW have always had a really good relationship, and it's the same guys who film all the shows and do a lot of the editing for CCW as well. It's Christiania TV. So they're based in Freetown, Christiania, and in Copenhagen. So they'll be filming the event, and it'll be going on Christiania TV, and it will be getting released online as well. We can't talk about where just now, but that we have spoke to a couple of different streaming services and stuff about hopefully Grunge, you know, continuing to appear on there, and being a weekly feature. But that's going to be, we're filming the first two episodes, so it's two episodes instead of one, and yeah, hopefully it's going to be in a few different places, but it will be online, so even if you're not in Denmark, you're still going to be able to check out.
And of course you have a bit of experience, of course, with a bit of TV taping through, of course, WWE Network, as we said, through ICW, and as the video content people watching would have seen, a little poster for Five Star Wrestling as well. If I mention Five Star, I'll start going to a rabbit hole of asking loads of questions about it. So
it's a rabbit hole. It's hard to get out.
It is. I was speaking to Demo recently. I don't know how I got on the podcast. Somehow jammed that. And we started speaking about Five Star, and I was like, I need to control myself here because I need to know everything about this promotion. But well, again, park it. It's not a Five Star Wrestling podcast. It's CCW. That's the point of this. This is why we're here. So yeah, TV taping. As someone with experience, then as a lot of the guys that are on the show that may not have had to work to a camera or anything like that, have they been kind of contacting you for a little bit of advice, or is that something you're going to try to maybe grab a couple folk aside on Saturday and try and get them to go, right, look here, kind of thing?
The guys have watched TV before. As I said, you know, they've got a good relationship with Christiania TV, so it's not going to be the first time that CCW has, you know, sort of been on that channel. But I think we're gonna treat it a lot more like a TV show now. Before it was very much a wrestling show that was being filmed and shown on TV. Whereas now, we want this to feel like a TV show, like a Monday Night Raw or an ICW Fight Club. It's TV. It's not just a stationary camera filming wrestling. There's going to be a bit more excitement to it. So I think there might be a slight learning curve for some of the younger guys, like we are bringing over, Ruby Roberts, for example, for a Scottish wrestler. I think this is going to be her first time for sure, working on TV and stuff. So there's going to be a learning curve for some of the guys. But I think we've got a lot of, experienced talent, a lot of new guys coming in and stuff. So there's a lot of new experience coming in as well. I think they're going to nail it. I think a lot of the guys are going to nail it. But if need be, if anyone does need the pointers or does need to, anything shown to them, then we've got people with that experience there that can point them in the right direction. So again, just all systems go, and hopefully we're going to knock it out of the park.
So quite a big talent roster that have been announced, just international as well, from Italy, Sweden, of course, Denmark, Scotland, and the US as well. But you mentioned Ruby Roberts, so we'll just dive into her match, because this is probably one of the marquee matches. I think it was one of the first ones properly announced as well for the tapings. But it's Ruby Roberts, Lexi Lux, in a hardcore match. First time ever in CCW. It was the first time ever. I mean, you're as a deathmatch wrestler, someone who's the blood tourist. Thoughts on this?
So this is probably, it's not probably, it's definitely the one that I'm most excited for. I'm going to be, I'm not going to be the only one. I think it's going to be a sellout of the curtain kind of thing. I'm definitely going to be watching it. But yeah, I'm excited for this. Lexi, I'm sure you had her on the Dojo podcast. She's been wanting to do the hardcore stuff and deathmatch stuff for a while. So with the kind of grunge thing, it fit the kind of vibe of the show, it fit the kind of aesthetic for what we were going for. So I thought, let's go for it, let's get it done here. I wasn't too sure what to expect. To be honest, at the start, it's like, is this, a trainee who's maybe got a bit too big for the boots, But then she sends in this promo with a knife, and it's like, no, I think Lexi Lux has already proved before the match even happened that she knows what she's doing with a weapon. If you can handle a knife that well, then clearly you've got some level of experience. But then on the other hand, you got Ruth. And she's from Coburnley, which in itself is some level of accolade in a fight, I guess. So she's no stranger to a rollerboot. As she said, insanity in the Scottish is genetic. It's tough for me to decide right now who my favourite's going to be. But if I can guarantee one thing, it's, and you have to excuse my language here, it's that these two pubs are going to knock fuck out each other.
When this match was announced, that was my exact thought, mainly because, like you said, I spoke to Lexi before for the Sharp Dojo series, so people need to go check that out, because it was just fascinating, because I knew nothing of Lexi, literally nothing, except that she was born in the US and came over to Sweden. That was all I knew about her. We had a bit of chat for an hour, and there were a little bit, I got the bit of the crazy chick vibe from her with the whole enamored with blood and deathmatch wrestling. I thought, you're definitely one I need to keep an eye on, just because I think you're going to be very interesting. I don't know how, but you're going to be very interesting to keep an eye on. And then the knife, promo. Yeah. I've watched it a few times, because I was like, she hasn't slowed it down. She's literally just like, there's no way I could do this on camera without making it look unsightly. But go check out CPH Wrestling on Facebook, and then that'll kind of explain it all. But no, she's a bit unstable, we'll say that. And she's coming up against Ruby Roberts, who, again...
If there was ever a promo that we didn't need a second take off, it was that one. But, when she sent that in, like, she made a point of letting us know that she can do it faster. That she had slowed it down for the video. And so, as I said, if she knows what she's doing that much with a knife, and she's been that excited to get into deathmatch wrestling and do a hardcore match and, you know, show what she can do, then when she's put in a sink or swim moment, I'm pretty sure that she's going to swim.
Absolutely. And I'll say about Ruby Roberts, who I've spoken to quite a few times now. And yeah, she's like you say, she's from Kilburnie. So she's already got the Scottish genetics of just being a fighter. And this is going to, like you're saying, it's going to be a curtain sellout. If I was just going, right, this is the only match announced, I still think you'd probably get a pretty good crowd out of it, because it's just going to be, it's not something you see nowadays.
I think it's exciting. Like, it's definitely, I think it may be the first women's hardcore match in Denmark, but I could be wrong, because I know Body Slam have done a couple of all women's shows, so there may have been a hardcore match on one of those. I don't know. But it's definitely the first women's hardcore match in CCW. And I'm just excited to see where the women's division in Denmark starts to go now. There is only one Danish women wrestler, and that's Elena. So now we're going to be bringing in women from elsewhere. And if, you know, we're going to create a women's division. So as I said, I'm excited to see where it goes. Jessie's already proved that she's a bit unhinged. You know, Ruth, I train Ruth myself down at the Spec Pro Wrestling Academy with Bobby Roberts and DCT as well. So I guess, you know, biased, I got to say, you know, if I've been working with Ruth on the lead up to this, I've been showing her a couple of the blood tourist tricks. So, you know, biased, I think Ruth has that advantage, but at the same time, you can't train mental. And Jesse's got that.
I'm very excited about hearing that they're trying to, that you're going to be building a women's division, because just from Scotland alone, we've got an incredible wealth of talent already sitting ready to be seen and to go. And of course, you've been everywhere around about Europe. I always joke about your little black book just being absolutely full of contacts, and no doubt you've already got loads of names from everywhere, from, I don't know, France, from other places in Scandinavia, from Hungary, wherever. You've probably got a list of names already that you're like going, right, flights to Denmark.
Well, if you're a women's wrestling fan, then the tip that I'll give you is you got to be watching Swedish wrestling right now. Like, there's a lot of exciting women wrestling going on in Sweden. So that's definitely somewhere that we're going to be bringing in women from. There's going to be a few of the Swedish girls coming in. But just in general, as I said, if you're a women's wrestling fan, another tip is check out CCW, because we're going to be building that women's wrestling division, and, you know, hopefully we're going to build one of the best in Europe.
I can't wait. I just like seeing characters, and that's, we're seeing a lot of them coming through, and of course Ruby and Lexi are just the epitome of death. There's a lot of character there, like, say, a bit stable, but, you know, it's still good. So yeah, that's the match that was announced first, and that was the one I was like, pretty much as soon as that match was announced or at least teased, that was, I must have contacted you very shortly afterwards, because I was like, that's the one I want to speak about. I want to at least get that previewed somewhere. If it's me doing it or someone else, if it's Kurt Johansson doing it, I want someone to talk about this match.
Absolutely.
But we've got loads more announced already. So what I can confirm, you've got a couple stuff that'll be going up over the, I don't want to spoil it for everyone, but I'm not recording this on Monday when this goes out.
It's all fake.
This is a podcast taping for a TV taping that's happening the next week. So you've got a little bit of things you can reveal that they'll be announced over the weekend before this goes out. So it won't be a spoiler. It'll be a spoiler for me, because I'll get to know before everyone else, which is nice. But we'll get into that. But I'll go through the matches that we have had already. We'll go for the International Three Flags Triple Threat, because there's another one where there'll be a name in this that I've chatted to, and it's been on the podcast feed before. We've got, I'm going to butcher names here. Is it Flowey from Italy?
Flowey, I believe it's pronounced. But at the same time, I may also be butchering that. I'm pretty new to Flowey as well. I believe it's pronounced Flowey.
Okay, so Flowey from Italy, Seb Silvers from Sweden, and Hunyadi Tamás as well from Hungary. So Hunyadi, yep. Of course, I've spoken to him for the Sharp Dojo series, which was a fascinating chat. Again, for some, at the time, I think he only had like handful of matches, and now he's, I've seen footage and pictures of him recently, and he's a bit more aggressive, a bit more, but yeah, he's less the soldier and more just, he's just coming in to just batter you for whatever reason. But so yeah, international three flags triple threat because of Italy, Sweden, Hungary. If you're putting in some input and putting this match together, you've wrestled all these places in these countries. Were you just kind of picking people that you think would go well together, or were you, I said, do you have any input when this match put together?
So just, I've always been a big fan of when promotions have that kind of international aspect. As a wrestling fan, a good kind of example of it would be, and some people think it's a bit cheesy, but I don't know, I like it. Like at All Star Wrestling, for example, when you got all the different international wrestlers and you got them all coming out with all the different flags and all that kind of stuff, I just always think it looks cool. And I like to see representation from different places around the world, different people getting represented. So you wanted to put a wee bit of that in. So we went with international triple threat. Coincidentally, it wasn't intended that way. But when the post went up, when the graphic went up, I realised that it's actually three guys who were regulars on the dojo. Flowey, Seb and Tanyade had all been, you know, on 90% of the dojo classes. They were always there. So for me, myself, that's one that I'm really looking forward to seeing how they've all came on, and you know, getting to see all these different styles from all these different places around the world, getting to see that all blended together into this one kind of mash of wrestling. So definitely excited for it. Seb Silvers has just been on Talang, which is the Swedish equivalent of Britain's Got Talent. And from what I can tell, everybody seems to be going mental for it. They're loving it. He was wrestling El Stuglisa, and I think that may be the only time I've ever pronounced that correctly. But he's been wrestling Stuglisa on like mats, but they're still going wild. They're hitting Hurricane Ranas on the stage and banging heads off the buzzers, and you know, it's been good stuff. It's been good TV. So I'm assuming that Denmark get access to that show as well. But you know, we get Swedes traveling over and stuff as well. So if they've been watching that, this is a chance to come and see them live. Come and see what's been blowing the minds of the Talang judges. But Flowey, is another one that I'm excited for. He's coming from IWA. I am the Italian Wrestling Association, which are based in Rome. I'm finally going to be making my debut for them this month, actually. But CCW are going to be having a kind of working relationship with them going forward. We're going to be doing, you know, some sort of talent swaps and stuff. As I said, I'm going to be going out there. We've got Flowey coming in. In the past, we've had Flavio Augusto, who's the IWA champion just now. We've had Chris Steele as well from Italy. So there's always been a bit of an Italian presence in CCW, but it will be exciting to see Flowey come in. I've been watching his videos and stuff. I was supposed to be wrestling him at one point as well, I believe. COVID and all that kind of stuff got in the way, but I've been watching his videos and I've been keeping an eye on him and stuff. So when we're putting this together, I thought, let's get one of the IWA guys in, let's get some you know, representation from there. And he was one of the most exciting guys from there. He's a kind of standout for me because, like you said, it's characters. And as I said earlier, we want a TV show. We don't want just a wrestling show. And he's a big character. You can tell, you know, with the wig and the mask and the tutu, and you know, it's all a bit wild. I can't put it in words. He's one of these acts that you need to watch it, and he's an experience. You know what I mean? He's not just a wrestler. So I'm looking forward to seeing him.
I mean, you mentioned like seeing flags and that. It's like everyone loves flags. Even if you don't want to admit it, it's like masked wrestlers, like masks, flags, and just ridiculousness. Props, that's the other thing, props that everyone likes. Of course, putting all three together, one of my favorites would be the Bulgarian Baker, has all three. Great. It's really an international flavor. You get to kind of.
I spoke about the other two when you said the Bulgarian Baker, to take it back to the Hungarian Baker, which is Hunyadi's side job when he's not a soldier and a wrestler. The Hungarian Baker, I've not spoke much about him. So he's another guy that's came through the dojo. He, you know, he He's been wrestling in Hungary. He's been wrestling in Body Slam in Denmark. He's been up at DPW. He's been all over Scandinavia in general. He was in IWA as well for the World Cup show that they did. So, you know, as you said, when you spoke to him for the Dojo podcast, he'd only had a couple of matches, but he's one of these guys that in the space of just a couple of months, he just went boom and just popped up everywhere. And there's a reason for that, you know what I mean? He's an exciting young wrestler who, as you said, beats the shit out of people, and it's fun to watch.
Yeah, and I mean, not to pardon the pun, but he's hungry. He's literally hungry to learn and to absorb all this and take it forward. I like that you're kind of using, not so much using this, but these guys are coming from obviously different home promotions and are coming into this one to kind of all battle it out. And you've got a bit of a working relationship with IWA. Again, an earth, I don't want to blow smoke up your ass too much in this podcast, but I've always said you've got a very sharp mind of networking. Pardon the pun, but you've got a sharp mind of kind of finding network opportunities. Have you found that be important when you're kind of helping put together these shows at CCW is creating these opportunities? Because I mean, like yourself, you've got respect as well. You train at Respect. You do W3L. You wrestle everywhere in Scotland and now in Europe. So have you found it important to create those network and opportunities anywhere you could?
I've always found it important to create network and opportunities for the obvious reasons, like as a wrestler. I guess I never really intended on creating sort of networking opportunities for CCW. They were just kind of already there from the wrestling side of it. Obviously, we're talking about IWA, my relationship with them kind of came around from the LKS dojo. We had a deal going on there, and obviously from them using me as well. And then even Seb Silvers, you know, before I got involved, CCW and SWS in Sweden, I've always had a good relationship. And that's where I seen him as well, was, you know, working at SWS. So I guess it does have its advantages. Obviously, if I'm going around Europe, I'm getting to see these different wrestlers, and I get to, you know, think back on the shows that I've been on and gone, right, who were the guys that stood out to me? Who were the guys that when I was watching the show that, you know, they kept my attention? Who are the guys that I think, you know, the Danish fans are going to want to see? So it definitely has its advantages. And I think that's something to expect from CCW going forward. It's Copenhagen's in the name, but there's going to be wrestlers from all over the world. You know, and that's not just guys that I've been on shows with. You know, I'm a big wrestling fan myself. I watch a lot of wrestling. I watch a lot of international wrestling. You know, I probably should watch more wrestling that's on TV, but for whatever reason, I've always enjoyed a bit of kind of independent international wrestling. So I've got my eyes everywhere. And, you know, the rest of the CCW management team and EV Entertainment and everything else, they've got their eyes everywhere as well. So there's going to be a lot of exciting guys coming.
It's very clear that you are a bit off the beaten path of your wrestling tastes when you're seeing who you're getting in for, like the Sharp Dojo series, Looking Sharp's Sharp Dojo, the series was the podcast, but the Sharp Dojo, you can see the people that you were getting in weren't your typical, it's this guy, he's really good at wrestling. You got guys like Mikey Whipwreck, who is a good wrestler in his own right, but he excelled at that, at getting emotion out of a crowd and stuff like that. And you brought in, again, Bull James, again, same reason. It was not necessarily all about the wrestling. And when it came to the Sharp Dojo, it was getting all these puzzle pieces to complete all these people that are watching their mini puzzles themselves.
100%. Like one of the things I always said on the dojo is every time you take a class, and it was a Prince Devitt seminar that I did, or Finn Balor seminar that I did years ago, and it was him that told us this. Every time you do a class, they're essentially giving you a piece of their puzzle. And, you know, throughout your career, every time you do a match or a class or whatever else, you get all these puzzle pieces, and you can pick the ones that you like and you can keep them, and the ones that you don't like, you can throw them away. But the ones that you keep, you put them all together, and that's how you create your own big picture, is by putting together all these little puzzle pieces that you've picked up along the way. So that was obviously what we're all looking to do with the dojo, is just give these guys as many different unique puzzle pieces as they could possibly get, so that when they create their own big picture. It's going to look nothing like anybody else's. It's going to be totally unique, and it's going to be totally, totally different. And you know, to tie it back into the show, I'm looking forward to seeing what all three of these guys have done with their puzzle pieces. Because one thing to keep in mind, if you're a fan of some of these guys that took classes on the dojo, is these are guys that have, you know, spent at least a couple of hours learning from these guys. You know, they've been learning from like Hector Guerrero and Bill James and Mikey Whipwreck, just incredible. They know the various kind of big name kind of stars that were on the dojo. These guys have sat under their kind of lemon tree, if you will. It's going to be exciting to see just what they've picked up from that.
Thankfully, you gave me a little bit of opportunity to, I know, I think media training, I suppose, I think that we could call it, but it was really just having a chat and not making an arse yourself for half an hour on a podcast. I think that's pretty much all I was given.
100%. If you can go on and not make yourself look like a dick, then we're getting something.
and it gave me guys like Nyadi and Lexi, and since then I've been keeping tabs on these guys, because I, when I spoke to them, I could tell how much they wanted it as well, and now we're getting to see them wrestling, and I'm looking forward to however this is distributed, finding out where. Of course, because I'm not going to Denmark this weekend, I don't want to spoil it for anyone that might not see me in the crowd, but I know I've got a very familiar look for everyone at the moment, it seems, as Gene Money pointed out, everyone's bald and got a beard, and, you know, here I am. But no, I'm looking forward to seeing especially those two matches. So the other match we've definitely got confirmed is your match. So we'll go for that one next. Well, I say we've got it confirmed. It's half confirmed. We know that your UAWA European Cruiserweight Championship, say that five times fast, is on the line. You'll be defending.
Yeah.
That's all we know. So I don't know if you'll find out on the night, or we'll find out by whenever.
This one's going to be kind of like an open challenge. I just want to put the opportunity out there for MD, who feels that they can step up, to come and do it. It's CCW Grunge. It's the first ever episode. It's a TV team, so if you want to come and make a name for yourself, then this is the chance to do it. You know, in terms of what the match is going to mean to me, I don't think I've spoken on a podcast or anything about this, but when I won the UEWA Cruiserweight title, that was my last appearance in CCW. And if you've seen the footage and seen the pictures, you'll know just, you know, quite how, what I went through to get it. You know, I ended up with two massive gashes on my head. I ended up, I had to duct tape my head back together to finish the match. And you know, the next day I was in the hospital for 2 days. I was passing out from blood loss. So I went through a lot to get the belt. You know, yeah, you're going to have to pretty much pry out my cold dead hands to put it simply.
Of course, that was a war with Nitro Green, wasn't it?
The Nitro Green, yeah.
Which ended up spilling over here as well. You end up having a little bit of a back and forth with Nitro at this side of whatever sea ocean it is to get here. So Nitro Green, I'm going to guess that, I mean, you'll be open to everyone, of course, to anyone coming forward. Nitro Green, is he probably, you've beaten him. You don't want, he's in the back of the line.
Back
burner.
I mean, I guess in theory, he could technically be the front of the line if you want to talk about rematch clause and all that kind of stuff. But he should be the back of the line. We've seen it. People have seen it. You know, how many times do you need to lose a belt to me before you get, you know, before you can stop cashing in your rematch clause, right? I've beaten you a couple of times. So we don't need to do that again. The CCW fans have seen it. Scottish fans have seen it now. So it's, you know, an international audience has been exposed to it. So let's, you know, Nitro can stay backstage, and we'll give the CCW fans something fresh for Grunge, something fresh for the first ever Grunge.
So from the matches, or from the talent that's been announced for the show that haven't got matches or at least haven't been announced for something yet. We've got guys like the Copenhagen Hangman, which I think you must have had a run-in with him before.
I've had a few run-ins with the Copenhagen Hangman. It seems over the sort of COVID period. He was previously kind of heading up the jury, which was a kind of faction that was going in CCW. But the numbers in that have kind of slowly dwindled. I mean, we still got obviously the Hangman, Sean the Freak still kind of floating around. You've got the Strangler, he's still there. But the numbers have dropped drastically from where it was before. So it's going to be interesting to see, you know, how the Hangman's dealing with that. Hangman was, as I said earlier, he's a former CCW heavyweight champion, but he didn't ever lose a belt. He had to drop the belt for, you know, due to health reasons. But he's back and he's fit now. So, you know, you've got to be wondering what he's thinking in terms of the belt as well. You know, he's definitely going to be wanting to put himself back into that picture. We can announce just now that Nitro Green last night won the CCW title from Hype Boy at Dance Pro Wrestling. So he's going to be defending the CCW title. It's the first ever Grunge. You know, the CCW title's got to be on the line at some point. And I think that there's a pretty good chance that the Copenhagen Hangman is going to be cashing in his rematch clause on Nitro Green. So Nitro is going to be getting a little sort of taste of his own medicine in terms of how annoying that can be.
Fair enough. I realise when I'm going, guys, that could possibly face you, I'm not really taking into account the cruiserweight aspect of all this as well. Yeah. Which, of course, will have a limit. But so we'll get on to Nitro Green and possibility of Hangman coming in to try and reclaim championship he never lost. But the other guys we've got again, these are names I won't be familiar with. I've got, I've got two here and I don't know how to say any of them. Sorte Kurt?
Sorte Kurt. He's a CCW favourite. I don't really understand Sorte Kurt. I think you might have to be Danish to kind of fully understand it. But what I take from it is he's kind of like Frank from Shameless, but Danish. he's kind of confusing. He doesn't talk much and drinks a lot. So more drinking, less talking is kind of Sorte Kurt's thing. But the CCW crowd absolutely love him. He hits a mean cut line, he calls it. The CCW crowd absolutely love him. So he's definitely going to be there in some capacity. I'm not too sure what it's going to be. He recently won, I believe it was 10,000 kroner in a battle royal. So I don't know, maybe he's going to be tricked out in a new jacket when he's got a fancy cane or something, I don't know. So he's come into money so we could see something from that. But he's definitely going to be there doing his thing, whatever that is.
Fair enough. I've got my mind like a drunk Orange Cassidy kind of
Kind of.
That seems like a character you could see in Scotland quite easily. Maybe not in the wrestling ring, maybe just outside. But yeah, that sounds interesting. We'll go with that.
Is definitely the most interesting wrestler in CCW, 100%. So yeah, Sorte Kurt's definitely someone to check out. He's a lot of fun.
You mentioned the Strangler. He's on this list of people that will be coming to the show. And I've got Emeritus.
Emeritus. So he's coming in from Body Slam. I believe this is the first time he's appeared in CCW in, I think it's 6 years. But he's been tearing up. He was in America years ago. I trained with Truth Martini. And worked a few shows over there. I believe he worked Chikara while he was out there. He's been back over. He's one of the kind of leading faces of Body Slam. He's recently just wrestled for the Ring of Honor title against Jonathan Gresham. That was the first time the Ring of Honor title has been defended in Nordics. So he's coming off hot from some like big performances. He's going to be one of the most exciting talents on the night, 100%. We can talk about his match. That should be announced by the time podcast goes out. So he's going to be wrestling the Strangler, who I mentioned from the jury. So we've got a bit of Lucha Libre going on there, two mask guys, which is going to be pretty cool. I've always been a big fan of Lucha Libre myself, so definitely wanted to get a wee bit of that in there. But the for me, these this is two veteran wrestlers, and there's a lot of young talent on the show, but this is two guys who know what they're doing, and it's another one of those ones where you can't decide who's gonna be the guy that comes out on top. It's gonna be the number one contender for the CCW title. So whoever comes out of this could be challenging Nitro Green at some point. But as I said, it's two veteran wrestlers who know what they're doing. Both guys have been, they've been on the Scandinavian scene for a number of years, and they've been tearing it up the whole time. Emeritus has, has been on a bigger stages, obviously wrestling for the Ring of Honor title and stuff. But Strangler is one of those guys that I'm really excited for people to. I think a lot of people might be seeing him for the first time, especially when we start sharing it online and stuff. The CCW fans obviously will be familiar with him, but hopefully when a kind of more international audience and stuff starts to see the shows, I think Strangler is really going to be one of the guys that stands out. I think people have, people have been missing out. He's been one of these guys who's been kind of tucked away in the Scandinavian scene, and I think he's just ready to just blow up. I think he's a brilliant wrestler.
What I'm getting together when we're talking about this is you've really you and the management team and what have you, you've really created a variety show, which is what you need as a TV taping, of course, because you go to the circus, you might like the clowns, but you don't want 2 hours of clowns. You want the acrobats as well, kind of thing. So you've a really varied card of death matches, Lucha Libre and everything in between that you could find. As someone who, I know yourself, you'll watch a little bit of everything to at least find something to like. It was that very important to make that as varied as possible so that it could be marketed to so many, to a wider audience, and it could check
absolutely out. Absolutely. I think as you said, like the circus is a the perfect example. Like there should be something for everyone. I want everyone and anyone to be able to come to the show and have a good time. One of the kind of unique things about CCW is that it feels like an ICW show that they let kids into. it's kind of got like an over 18s vibe, but they let kids in there as well. So we want there to be something for the kids, we want, something that the kids can enjoy, but we want something for the adults as well. There's a seated section where the kind of kids and the families will be, and then there's a standing section for the kind of the drunken, the kind of rowdy folk. So we want to be pleasing all sides of the building, we want everybody to have something. It definitely was important to get that covered and just make sure that there's something for everybody to enjoy.
Just give them prior warning to cover their eyes when Ruby and Lexi are out and with knives and that, because just cover the eyes. It'll be fine. Don't worry about it. So the other thing we've got that was confirmed, I can at least I know a little bit about, is the Easy Lovers are in action.
Yeah.
And watch me butcher at least two of these names. We've got Bam Bam Quaid.
Yep.
Eric Sable and Jackpot.
Spot on. I believe it's Quaddy. I think it's pronounced Quaddy, but again, I might be butchering that as well. But these are just really exciting guys that I've seen. I've been watching them at Body Slam. When we started talking about new guys to bring in, these were the first guys that came to mind, like 100%. First off, they're Danish. They're already in Denmark, and they were already, one of, if not the most exciting act in Denmark. Definitely one of the most talked about. There's a reason for that. When they've got that much buzz around them, we want to bring that to CCW, and we want CCW to be part of that. All three of them have got their own sort of unique kind of aspects to them. Much like the show covers about everything, the Easy Lovers themselves cover about everything. And again, they're just uber entertaining. They're going to be some of the standouts for the show. Bam Bam Quaddy, he's my sort of personal favourite. He's a big heavyweight wrestler. And I think he's gonna be a difference maker in CCW. There's a kind of a lack of big guys. And I think some of the big guys who have been on the roster for a while have got kind of too comfortable on the spot. I think he's going to shake things up a wee bit coming onto the roster and kind of maybe putting some of these guys in the place.
So, I mean, one name I haven't really mentioned that's been announced is Sebastian Day, of course, who you'll be very familiar with. And our guy we spoke to, he's quite when I spoke to him, he would be humble. I think that seems to be a good word I can describe him. He's quite laid back and just chilled and, yeah, I'm not bad kind of thing. But when you see him wrestle, you go, you're actually better than not bad. So let's just, like believe in yourself a little bit. So, yeah, Sebastian Day, again, he's a guy that's synonymous with CCW. So that's was a no-brainer. He was going to be involved in some way or form or fashion. But for those that haven't seen Sebastian Day before, what would you kind of, how would you sell him to someone who's seen CCW for the first time?
Sebastian's one of the, he's one of the veterans of the CCW roster. He won the first ever Copenhagen Cup, and then went on to be the first ever CCW champion. And since then, he's held his own against the absolute best, you know, not just in Scandinavian wrestling, but in the world. He held the CCW title for a long time. And in that time, you know, as I said, he was wrestling people from all over the globe. He was wrestling people from Italy, Flavio Augusto and Chris Steele, that I mentioned earlier, were two of the guys that Sebastian had wrestled. And then he had, his most notable match of that title run was against Angelico. Just before he went off to AEW. And obviously, if you're coming out on top against guys like Angelico, who, you know, went on to wrestle for, you know, one of the biggest promotions in the world, then you're definitely doing something right. So maybe Sebastian, as you said, yeah, he's humble, but he's very, very talented. I don't know in what capacity Sebastian is going to be showing up. He was recently injured, and Sebastian's got a bit of a tendency to get injured because he just throws himself in every 100 miles an hour. And sometimes when you're going 100 miles an hour, you hit a wall. But he's coming back. He's fighting fit. And as I said, I don't know what capacity he's gonna be there. He could be coming out to come after my UEWA Cruiserweight title. He's in the right weight class. Obviously, Nigel Green's going to be defending the CCW title, so he might want to make that a three-time champion. So I'm just excited to see him back in the ring. And as I said, he's one of the CCW veterans, so if you want to check out CCW, he's a good place to start. Arguably the best.
So we've covered all the matches that will be announced by the time that our chat goes live or goes out for everyone to hear. So just to recap them for anyone who may have missed it. So we've got the International Three Flags Triple Threat, Flywee versus Seb Silvers versus Hinyadi Tomas. We've got the hardcore match, which the one I'm super excited for, Ruby Roberts versus Lexi Lux. We've got the CCW Heavyweight Championship online, Nitro Green defends. We don't know who against, but there's plenty of options that it could be. You're defending your UEWA European Cruiserweight Championship. Again, don't know who against. It could be anyone that we've mentioned tonight. It could be someone who's already up. Who knows? It could be Lexi Lux. We don't know. It could be anyone. And then we've got the Strangler against
Emeritus.
Thank you. I should have really just wrote them out, like how they're, you know, how you get on Wikipedia, they've got the complicated name, and then in brackets it's got how it sounded out. I should have just done that instead. And then we've got guys like Sorty Kurt coming along, and the Easy Lovers. So it's a packed show for the first TV taping, for the first two episodes of CCW Grunge. So we mentioned all that. There is going to be English commentary as well. So is there a local language commentary as well? Will there be a Danish commentary for?
There will be Danish commentary for the sort of local audience. But there will be English commentary. I think it's an important part of sort of expanding. So again, from my kind of own experiences and dealing with them, I always thought that Kurt Johansson was really good in that aspect. And it was him that suggested bringing in Jonas as well. So the two of them are going to be our English commentary team going forward. Kurt's obviously got a wee bit of experience doing it now, I believe, at Odyssey. Is it Odyssey Pro Wrestling? So he's obviously got a wee bit of experience doing it down there. I believe it might be John's first time. I could be wrong. But I think the two of them are going to knock it out of the park. There was a great reaction for them online. Everybody seemed, you know, excited to see them. I'm the same. I think I'm going to knock it out of the park.
Kurt's definitely one of the guys. I'm going to guess he's going to have such a knowledge because he did, of course, the Scandigrap series his podcast as well. The Kurt Johansson Show. I've spoken to on a podcast in the past. So he has got like a great love for the Danish scene. And I think when it was announced he was going to do some commentary, I thought that's obviously it's going to be Kurt Johansson. He's quite a kindred spirit with yourself, who's got a lot of love for this territory in Europe. That's coming out. And Johnners, of course, he does a lot of backstage stuff, a lot of backstage things. He's got a podcast himself. He does the Wrestling with Johnners podcast. This actual podcast will be on the Wrestling with Johnners website because we're part of their big network of podcasts. There's two very experienced people. Whether it's experience as a commentary team together, not so much, but they definitely got a lot of knowledge that they can bring, hopefully, to CCW Grunge. When it comes to international distribution.
100%. I think one of the things that I've realised that we've not touched on, I think because they're not on the poster, they've maybe kind of slipped my mind. But it's, you know, should have been one of the first things is the new owners of CCW. EV Entertainment, CCW was taken over by Victor Victorious and Emil. So they're definitely going to be there in some capacity. They're not the kind of guys to just sit backstage and, you know, enjoy the show from behind the curtain. Very much like to be out there in spotlight. Making a bit of a scene, so I'm sure EV Entertainment are going to be making a bit of an impact on either episode one or episode two of CCW Grunge. But I guess it's just a case of showing up and finding out what's going to happen.
So I'm getting that. Yeah, they like to show off their it's their show, and if it's going well, they're going to absolutely take all the credit for it. It was theirs.
Last they had the confetti going off last time and. You know, the dry ice guns and all this kind of stuff. So they like to be kind of flash when they come in, show off a bit. You know, this whole I'm better than you kind of vibe. So that's their thing, and it's up to them to do things how they want to do it. But I'm pretty sure that at CCW Grunge, you know, it's that I'm better than you vibe isn't going to work at Grunge. That's not what it's about, and I'm pretty sure somebody's going to take exception to that. And there's, you know, we've already spoke about a few guys like the Easy Lovers and Sebastian Day, the Hangman, Nitro. There's a lot of guys who are on the show, but, you know, there's a bit of kind of uncertainty there. So I guess EV Entertainment, you know, maybe this is a show to tone it down, because this is one that's most likely somebody will put one in their jaw.
It's one of those when you go to an underground club, which obviously I've done frequently. Look at me. But if you go to an underground club and you turn up in a really fancy, I know, I've dug myself into a hole in this analogy, but I'll get there. You go in there with like a fancy blazer or some cords, khaki cords or something, like you're so out of place. That's what EV Entertainment would be in this grunge environment.
Oh, 100%. And I think just that this whole, it's a reinvention with CCW Grunge. So I think going forward, people have seen what EV Entertainment were like in the past in the old CCW. So I think they'll try and stop them in their tracks pretty early this time.
Wonderful. So we'll get some closing bits and pieces in a moment, but I'll recap everyone how to get tickets or where it's going to be. So it's going to be at Sports Factory in Copenhagen, Saturday, March 12th. Doors open at 6 p.m. Show starts at 7. So plenty of time for you to get a seat and get your stuff, merch, and I'm assuming there'll be, will there be a bar? I don't know.
Yeah, there'll be drinks on sale. There'll be plenty of drinks on sale. Sorry, Kurt would not be in the venue if there wasn't drinks on sale.
Of course.
Yeah, there's good dice, drinks, all that good stuff.
Excellent. So you can find out more TV taping, episode 1 and 2 being taped on that night. You can find out more at facebook.com/CPHWrestling. You'll also find out where I'll get your tickets there as well. I was going to read out the website. I looked at it and thought, no. I really kind of struggled with all the names of the wrestlers. I wasn't really going to go for that either. But you can find it out, facebook.com/CPHWrestling and also twitter.com/CPHWrestling1. They'll have all the information. Don't worry about it. It'll keep you right. So we went through the show. I think we've mentioned, is there anything we've really missed that you can reveal that'll be out by the time this goes out on Monday?
No. Covered everything? I don't think there's anything that we've missed. I think we've covered just about everything. At the March show, there'll be a kind of pre-sale option for the Sicker Than Your Average show in May. Which will obviously have Warhorse, who you've seen on MLW, AEW, loads of different kind of big-time stages. So there'll be a pre-sale option for those wanting to check out the May show. You can get the tickets a wee bit cheaper. But other than that, I think we've covered everything.
Excellent. So, I mean, other than your match, because I'm guessing that'll be the best match on the card if you have your way with it, If you're trying to sell the show on one match to anyone who's never been to CCW before, that would kind of, this is the match you have to see, what one, and I know there's plenty of choices, but which one would you kind of go, this is the one you need to see on this show?
Easy. It's the women's hardcore match, 100%. Like, CCW Grunge is new. It's a reinvention of CCW, where like a whole new attitude, a whole new roster, all new faces. And for me, this match is the embodiment of that. Like, you know, there wasn't much of a women's wrestling presence in CCW before. By all means, you know, there had been women's wrestling matches there, but there wasn't a division, and there will be going forward. There will be, you know, women's wrestling on these shows. But not only that, it's going to be unique. There's going to be women's hardcore matches. We're going to be seeing, you know, the likes of, you know, Lexi Lux and Ruby Roberts, you know, getting told in, you know what I mean? We're not going to be, you know, it's not going to be some sort of side attraction. It's very much going to be a main aspect of the show, and I'm looking forward to seeing that. And the, you know, the hardcore element of it is just going to be part of CCW in general. Like, that's going to be a big part of CCW, and I think these two are really going to set the tone for that. So definitely the women's hardcore match. That's going to be the, if you want to check out CCW, if you want to know what we're going to be all about going forward, that this match is going to tell you that this is CCW.
Excellent. Well, I think we've previewed the show pretty well. I think, I mean, like I say, if you're in the Copenhagen area, you need to get to this, just because the match, the lineup is just insane. And I mean, even if you want to take a wee jaunt to Europe over the weekend, I don't know what the rules are with masks and that, but
is a wonderful company.
Exactly. Keep interrupting each other. I'll let you finish your thought.
cut this bit. I was putting over Ryan.
All right, okay, that's fine. No, we don't need to put them over. They make enough. But no, there's plenty. Get your tickets. Get over to the show, and who knows? Maybe we'll, in the future, way back in the future, we'll make it. I don't know a Scottish UK taping. A UK taping of CCW. The possibilities are absolutely endless. But no, thank you very much for joining me today and previewing CCW Grunge. Lou, where can we find you on social media, and where can people just get to us if you've got any queries or questions about the about CCW?
So you can check myself out at facebook.com/LouKingSharp, at LouKingSharp UK on Twitter and on Instagram. And then there is Looking Sharp TV on YouTube as well, so you can check me out on any of those places. You can check out Looking Sharp TV if you want to go back and check out some past CCW matches on there, and there's some clips and some full matches on there as well that you can check out. And of course, CCW is on all your kind of all your social medias as well. You can check us out on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and there's a CCW YouTube channel as well, where again you can check out some past CCW footage.
Perfect. Well, thank you very much for joining me today.
Well, thank you very much for having me on there. I appreciate it.